Hey, what's up? Mirte here, and this is my first video of the muscular system series. So in this segment, we're going to cover all the muscles of mastication, which are a part of the muscles of the head. Alright, so all muscles of the head are divided into two groups. The first group is the muscles of mastication. Mastication means to chew, so those are all the muscles responsible for chewing when you're eating. And the second group is going to be the facial muscles, or the muscles that are going to be responsible for facial expression. So we're going to focus on the mastication muscles here. So in this video, we're going to cover the origin and the insertion point of the four muscles of mastication, which are the temporal, masseter, medial pterygoid, and the lateral pterygoid muscles. And then in the next video, we will cover the facial muscles. Alright, before we start, I want you to have a basic understanding of what makes up the different parts of the muscle. All the muscles in our body consist of an origin point, which is the part of the muscle that is attached to bone that does not move or move a very slightly bit during contraction. It has a head, which is the proximal part of the muscle. There's a belly, which is the widest part of the muscle. Then there's a tail and an insertion point, which is the part of the muscle that's attached to bones that moves during contraction. So, when you're studying the muscles in general, the origin and insertion points are what we usually focus on. And again, keep in mind that the origin point is the least movable part, and the insertion point is the part of the bone that moves during contraction. In some occasions, you will also see the word belly. Usually, if the muscle is divided into two parts, that's when we mention this term. Let's now cover the muscles of mastication. The muscles of mastication, again, consist of the temporal muscle, masseter muscle, medial pterygoid muscle, and the lateral pterygoid muscles. So when the next time you take a bite of the hamburger, these are the muscles that help you mechanically grind through the food inside of our oral cavity. Alright, so the temporal muscle look like this. It originates from the temporal fossa, which is the fossa located on the temporal bone, and it also originates from the inferior temporal line on the parietal bone. The fibers then go down behind the zygomatic arch, as you see here, and attaches to the coronoid process of the mandible, which is here. And so, what is the function of this muscle? When the anterior fibers contract, they will elevate the mandible, and when the posterior fibers contract, they will retract the mandible, as you see here. So, that's this one. Next, we have the masseter muscle, which is this one. If you look closely, you will see that it consists of a superficial part, and a deep part, but they both originate from the same structure. The superficial part originates from the anterior part of the zygomatic arch, while the posterior fibers originate from the posterior part of the zygomatic arch. Fibers then insert at the masseteric tuberosity at the mandible, and when these fibers contract, they will elevate the mandible. Next, we have the medial pterygoid muscle, and to see this one, we need to look at the head from this perspective. So the medial pterygoid muscle is located on the other side of the masseter muscle. And what are the origin points? If you zoom in, you will see that it has a superficial part and a deep part. The superficial part originates from the maxillary tuberosity, and the deep part originates from the pterygoid fossa of the pterygoid process. These fibers go down and insert at the pterygoid tuberosity of the mandible. The function of this muscle is either elevation of the mandible if both the right and the left medial pterygoid muscles contract, and if only one side contracts, they move the mandible in a frictional masticatory movement, a grinding movement kinda. Then lastly, we have the lateral pterygoid muscle, which is located laterally to the medial pterygoid muscle. So if you go back to this view and remove all the muscles, and then you remove the mandible, we'll be able to see this muscle very easily. And so, this muscle is also divided into two parts. It's divided into the superior head, which originates from the infratemporal surface, as well as the sphenoid bone, and an inferior head, which originates from the lateral lamina of the pterygoid process. These two heads kind of join together to insert into a common area at the pterygoid fovea of the mandible, which is here, right here. The functions of this muscle is to move the mandible forward if both the right and the left side contract together, or produce a frictional masticatory movement if only one side contracts. So that was all I had for the muscles of mastication. The next video is going to be about the muscles of facial expression.